How's it going, everyone? Today, we'll be taking a look at an entry-level Intel Z790 motherboard by Gigabyte, the Z790 UD, positioned as more of a no-frills offering that still serves up Intel's top-of-the-range Z790 chipset for those of you looking to build a higher-end Intel 13th generation Raptor Lake PC. Let's see if this board is any good. Now, the UD series, short form for Ultra Durable, refers to products in Gigabyte Stable that are targeted more at value-conscious end users, where it places below the Gaming X series of products targeted at gamers on a budget and below the Aura series of enthusiast class offerings. In view of this, the box comes in the usual greyish-black colorway that has an Ultra Durable motif splashed across the front in a bronze color, and moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll cover these specs in depth later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Now let's set aside the board for now to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with the Z790 UD. Given that this is more of a no-frills kind of motherboard offering, we get just a quick start leaflet right here. And this is accompanied by two SATA 3 cables, as well as three M.2 drive screws. And with that, here we have it, the Gigabyte Z790 UD. As you can see, it sports a black PCB with grey motifs to add some visual interest to the board. Again, as a no-frills motherboard offering, the Z790 UD does not come with any integrated RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with a handful of RGB headers. I'll talk about the placement of these headers later on in this video. It's great to see that Gigabyte's gone for an integrated I/O shield design with chunky black heat sinks for the VRMs, where we get a 16+1+1 power delivery solution with 60A DR MOS power stages, meaning to say that this board should handle Intel's high-end 13th generation CPUs with ease. I must say, while Gigabyte's probably saved some money by leaving the integrated I/O shield unpainted, I personally think that the brushed aluminium appearance still looks pretty nice. A passive heatsink is used to cool the Intel Z790 chipset, and in terms of M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte included a heatsink for just one out of the three M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. In terms of memory support, the Z790 UD comes with 4 DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 7600 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. Near the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that provides support for up to 2 front panel USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and we do also get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to two front panel USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on to some of the special features that this board comes with, we see that Gigabyte included a serial port header right here. We do also get a TPM header that allows you to install an optional TPM module, a Qflash Plus button that allows you to update the motherboard's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, a multi-key switch that can be programmed from within the BIOS to serve a variety of different functions, such as to allow end users to reset the PC or boot directly into the BIOS, and so on. Moving on, we get a set of status LEDs right here that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. Finally, moving up top, we get a pair of Thunderbolt headers that allow you to install an optional Thunderbolt add-on card that is sold separately by Gigabyte. In terms of expansion slots, the Z790 UD comes with a single PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card, where the slot comes with the ultra durable armor feature that reinforces the slot against heavy graphics cards. The said slot also sports the PCIe Easy Latch feature. Now, PCIe Easy Latch is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab which allows you to remove a graphics card from the motherboard in a completed PC build with ease. We do also get two PCIe 3.0 X1 slots, a PCIe 3.0 X16 slot that operates at X1 mode, as well as a PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. For your storage devices, Gigabyte has included 6 SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. In terms of M.2 slots, the Z790 UD comes with 3 PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that these 3 slots support NVMe SSDs only. SATA M.2 drives are not supported. For audio, Gigabyte included an entry-level Realtek ALC-897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of another Realtek part, the RTL8125BG, that serves up support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. In the cooling and RGB departments, the Z790 UD comes with 6 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 2 addressable RGB headers and 2 12-volt standard RGB headers located in these areas of the board. In terms of rear I/O connectivity, Gigabyte included 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a PS2 keyboard and mouse combo port, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a DisplayPort 1.2 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.0 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the Gigabyte Z790 UD shapes up to be an interesting offering of a budget-oriented Intel Z790 motherboard. It serves up high-end features at a wallet-friendlier price, at least when compared to other competitor Z790 motherboard offerings out there, making it perfect for end users who don't really care for frills such as a gamer-oriented aesthetic, fancy accessories, and so on. In spite of its value-oriented pedigree, we get features that matter, such as a beefy VRM setup, PCIe Gen 5 connectivity for a graphics card, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and a slew of good-to-have quality-of-life features, such as PCIe Easy Latch, and so on. As of March 2023, the Z790 UD can be had for a price of around SGD 385 through offline and online retailers. For you international viewers, this converts to roughly $286. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.